Hello everybody. In this tutorial, we shall talk about data historians in a typical SCADA system. As usual, we shall explain the concept with a sample application, with the complete source code, in the TwinCAT environment. If you have not subscribed to our channel, consider subscribing to our channel. A data historian is a type of time series data, designed to collect, store, and process data from an automated system efficiently. So data can be collected, stored, and processed to see how well the system is performing. Data historian allows operators and stakeholders to look at historical data for the plant. Data historian is a software program that records and retrieves production and process data over time. Some software systems clearly define event and data historian separately. Arbitrary server symbols of the TwinCAT HMI can be historized by the TCHMI SQLite Historize extension. The extension saved the data in a ring buffer in an SQLite database. The interval at which data are saved in the database can be defined for each symbol. The historical data are displayed in control. The control name is Trendline Chart. The control enables the display of various historical data at the same time. Let's take a look at how our yard gate sample works. We have a gate in our yard in our fictitious home automation system. In the gate control system, we have open and closed button. We have also another button for simulating an obstacle. If an obstacle is in front of the gate, then the gate should stop, and when the obstacle is removed, then it should continue closing or opening. When we press on the obstacle button, it brings a dog and paws the gate. The dog image can be toggled by pressing on the button again. So presence of an obstacle changes the activity time. We can open or close the gate by pressing on the open or close button. We can observe the data, how many times it had obstacles and how long it took to open or close the gate. As you see, here is the test application for generating historical data. We open the gate. We introduce an obstacle by pressing the toggle obstacle button, so the gate stops. The dog has appeared on the path. Opening continue as we have removed the obstacle. When the open proximity sensor changes color, then we can close the gate. Also, note the output signal changes its color. We also enable and disable the buttons. And it has different opening time and closing time, so we can have different types of graphs. For opening and closing case, the remaining time changes differently. Remaining time is plotted in y-axis. And the actual opening time or closing time is plotted in x-axis. We can historize different variables as needed by our projects. So now if we stop this recording, and we can examine different value of the symbol. We can know how long it took actually, and how many times it had obstacles and so on. We can do further analysis by zooming and now the individual value can be examined. At different times, we have different values for our historized symbols. With obstacles, we see remaining time is flat, meaning no changes. It has a remaining time value at this point, 6080, and here we had 5070 and so on. From these data, we can get very accurate information about what was happening in our yard gate. We are developing the historian part in this tutorial. Other parts such as the PLC program and animation will be discussed in other tutorials. Here is the sample that we don't have anything related to that TwinCAT historian. So we are starting from scratch how use data historian in TwinCAT. But we need to have the PLC program which will drive the yard gate. Also we need to have the HMI. Having said that, let's start learning how did we develop the application which we just saw. We need to check what the version of TwinCAT engineering we are using for development. TCHMI SQLite Historize does the actual recording. Wrong extension version may not work properly. We go to HMI server config page for checking the version. As we see, our engineering version is 1.12.75 2.0. We add the same extension version to our solution. With other versions, it may malfunction. Now we go back to Visual Studio. Then to the reference folder of our solution. Right click. Manage Nugget Package. And press on Browse tab. Type TwinCAT in the search field. Find the SQLite Historize. Select SQLite Historize, then select that right version from drop-down list. We select 752.0. So this is our HMI engineering version. Press on the install button. Okay, now the extension is installed. This can be verified from the reference list. Sklyta Historize has been added to the reference. We need to bring the mapped server symbol so we can historize the variable. We are going to historize only one variable, and that is remaining time left. Here is the remaining time, and then I do that history settings. All the default settings are fine. So we are telling by this how many entries will be stored in the database. And then what is the interval of data recording? We can change the settings if we think, but all these are fine for us. So I press OK. And now there is an icon beside the historize symbol that indicates that it is a historicized symbol. We can historize more than one symbol in real project. Now I close the window. We bring this toolbox and do drag and drop the trend line chart to desktop view. Many of the default settings are fine in the chart. We need to still configure some settings and tell what data we are going to display and so on. So we select the line chart and bring the property windows. We configure all the needed parameters one by one. All these settings are available on the InfoSys page. Please take a look at those pages for more information. First, we configure the x-axis. We rename the default x-axis name to open/close time. We change x main tick steps to 20. We can select different values which fit to our requirement. X show labels to unchecked. We keep show x-axis checkbox checked. Now we can configure the y-axis. We plot changes of remaining time in y-axis. Press on the ellipse to configure the y-axis. Y-axis editor is opened. We change the main tick max value to 15,500, which is the possible max value of the waiting time. We change the axis name to remaining time. And press OK. We do changes to some other parameters for convenience. We change the start parameter in the comment section. We shall use the latest 2 minutes of data for plotting. We can take a look at the details on the InfoSys page. InfoSys page has description of all the parameter which we use here. By default, start parameter has a value first. The first means the first available data should be used in historize. Other value of the parameter can be, such as latest 2 minutes, 3 minutes etc., based on our need. We want to tell the extension to use latest 2 minutes of data. We can set the parameter to PT2M. PT2M means use the available data from the latest 2 minutes. We tell the TwinCAT to use latest 2 minutes of data. Next, press on the line graph description ellipse. Editor is opened. We click on the Add button. Select the symbol that we are going to historize. Note that we selected the variable and historized previously. Close the symbol selection editor by pressing OK. We can add multiple symbols if needed. We select the Y-axis ID from the drop-down. We must have created the Y-axis during Y-axis configuration. Finally, we select the line color depending on our choice. We select the red color. We can select also point.fill and stroke color. Finally, we press the OK. We have a few more settings to check. Mostly, all default values are fine. We keep selected the show menu bar by which we can start, stop, zoom, etc. We select the show tooltip also. Show tooltip should be displayed in stop mode. We can do further configuration of tooltip if needed. We close the property window. Let's test the application by live view. Live view is a quick way to test TwinCAT HMI. The gate is moving as the result of the open button press previously. The extension module is already displaying on the line chart. Open limit switch in on means the gate is open. Close the gate. We can introduce an obstacle and there is a dog in front of the yard. The gate has stopped. The closing time is increasing in the horizontal direction, because we have obstacles on the path. The PLC program is doing the actual work. We removed the obstacle. Now the door is closing. The gate image is animated according to the PLC program. We open one more time, wait until the closed limit switch in on, and we can open one more time. The door is opening. In the beginning, both opening and closing cases reset the remaining time to default. Now the door is opened, note that the open switch changing color. Now we close the gate. The gate is closing. Our objective is to find how the remaining time changes with obstacles. Clearly, obstacles will increase the activity time, which can be understood later from the data. Now if we pause this, then you can do an analysis. We can check what happened during this time, for example how long it took and why it took so long. Basically, it can tell us what happened in the past. How that remaining time changed over time. And we had an obstacle here and then the barrier was removed at this point and continued. This is like historical view of our system. From this historical data, we can find all the business parameters for optimizing our process or improving our process. So this is like historical view of our system, so it can give idea when and what happened in our system. In real system, we need to monitor many variables and based on the parameters, we can optimize our process. Data are saved to SQLite and later can be analyzed in offline. I hope you get some idea about what is data historian and how we can use it in TwinCAT environment. If you have any question, you could ask to our Google group or comment in the YouTube channel. Don't forget to share this in your network. So thank you very much. And that was all. So if this video was useful, consider subscribing to our channel. We have many sample at hemilix.com. Visit our website for more interesting sample code, tutorial for automation specially for TwinCAT development. See you in next episode.